读书能让我更懂得人性的丰富，世界的多彩。在书的引导下，去领略人间的沧海桑田，去尝遍人生的酸甜苦。
是一个让你可以和古人聊天、对话，可以和大师开展头脑风暴的最好的途径。
读书让我广博科学文化知识，增强自己看问题的能力。
书籍就像阳光、雨露和空气，滋养着我们的生命。
书可以延展生命的长度，提升境界的高度。
Reading is a good habit, and do not go to bed early and read more books. Reading can help us build a second interpersonal relationship, and reading can also help us build a second society. Books bring us afar and also help us understand the infinite possibilities of life and the world. Nanjing, a capital city of six ancient dynasties in China, is the city of literature. What is the biggest potential, the capacity of literature? It is to remind everyone to have a heart. I think a city has its own spirit and temperament, which comes from its books and its citizens' reading habit and their mind of accepting the classics. One scholar used to describe the beauty of Nanjing, saying that Nanjing's beauty is beyond a description. The beauty lies in the mountains and rivers, lies in its deep history and its people's life. By walking on the city streets, you are interacting with the scholars and the literators who used to stay in this place in our history. So the city is full of literature experience. Then it must be a sustainable developing city. Dear online viewers and also viewers in front of the TV, welcome to this episode on the reading in Nanjing. Now let's welcome our guest, Mr. Li Jingze, President of China's Writers Association, and Mr. Bi Feiyu, the Vice Chairman of China's Writers Association, and also Mr. Li Bo, Professor from Nanjing Normal University, and Mr. Chen Jun, head of the Nanjing Library, and I'm also glad to be joined by my colleague Zhang Shuyue. Welcome to our program. Today, each guest brings their own recommend book to be recommended to the audience. Well, as I came from Nanjing, I'd like to recommend a special piece I like very much. It is Chinese name is Wenxin Diaolong of the Chinese literature, Liu Xie. Mr. Lu Xun once said, this book is for opening up our horizon and opening up the horizon to the world. So it is a masterpiece of a literature critic. So I'd like to recommend this book to everyone. I like this book very much. Well, I think many Chinese, despite their love for books, they may not have read this book. But this book is really very influential. So an ancient literator called Shen Yue in the time of Liu Xie, the writer, the author of the book. Mr. Shen Yue did not recommend the book of Liu Xie of others, but he specially recommended the book of Liu Xie because their dynasty is said to be a dynasty where Chinese awareness is rising, and this book is very critical to the dynasty because it stresses the logical thinking, the logical deduction, the Chinese literature style is combined with literature itself. I don't believe that the literators, when they the Western style is about reasoning, but this book is about creating itself. So in the Wei and Jing dynasties, so from Wei and Jing dynasties to the South and North dynasties, Chinese people's understanding of literature has reached a particular height. So this book is not a peak by itself. I think the speaker has mentioned Mr. Zhong Rong, another author. You know, Mr. Shen Yue, as we mentioned, belongs to Nanjing. The poetic style laid a solid foundation for the rhythmic beauty of the Chinese poems. So in this sense, by so far, we can appreciate the beauty left by a cultural legacy of the Wei and Jing dynasties. So they have been embedded in our blood. So we can say some books are read by a great amount of people, but some books are read by few, yet they have been embedded into our blood and DNA. The sense of the literature lies in the words. We like to seek truth. You need to practice a lot before things become mature, or practice makes perfect. So not only this book, Wenxin Diaolong, but also famous pieces come from Nanjing. A lot of other works, like A Search for the Deities, all came from Nanjing. They have a special connection to the city of Nanjing. And also, since we have many renowned poem writers like Li Bai and Li Qingzhao, and to name a few, and those pieces were either inscribed in Nanjing or created in Nanjing. So Nanjing was lifted up to its fame as a UNESCO City of Literature. So We have another Chinese book that is very famous to the Chinese people, and is said to be the earliest version of the Weibo style writing style. So the name of the book is called A New Account of the Tales of the World. This book has been living up to its fame until today, and that is very rare. We got wisdom from the book. We need to appreciate the generations of ancestors who passed this book down. So today we have invited a 99-year-old Mr. Shen to join us on site. I can still drink much alcohol, even today. I think you posted a very interesting episode on your WeChat circle. So what does it mean? My name is Shen Xiyue. I'm 99 years old. I work in Nanjing Library. I have retired, but working in the library is the only thing I have done throughout my life. The first thing is to procure books. And he is a special expert in the catalog, and he has participated in the compilation of many famous pieces, especially the ancient classics. So he is really an expert in ancient classics. He can tell you whether this book is worth reading or not at a first glance. And he goes to the library on time every day. I never think I will turn old. And I never imagine one day that I will not work. And after 30 years after he retired, he is still dedicated to what he has worked for a lifetime. So, Huang Pilie's book, in Qing Dynasty, a book is highly appreciated. A lot of scholars from Qing Dynasty has commented on the edition, and Mr. Shen aimed to produce a more improved version. So he has done something really great to the literature circle. We also expect Mr. Shen to produce the work as early as possible. Mr. Shen is too old to use a computer, but the whole book amounts to 800,000 Chinese characters. Finally, in 2018, the book was finished. It is a legacy, you see what I mean? It is a treasurable cultural legacy. Throughout his lifetime, he reads books, he loves books, he protects books. His life is closely related to books. Books bring me progress. Books give me joy. Books give me a sense of accomplishment. So I am the reader, Shen Xiyuan. I don't think Mr. Shen is old at all. If you are dedicated to something, you are never old. So how to preserve the cultural legacy that is over thousands of years old? Classics witness the passing of times. Even a thin piece of paper can witness a long history. A special group of people work against the time to protect the time print of the ancient classics. The ancient classics refers to the works that is printed, produced between 1912. Due to environmental and maintenance reasons, are more easily subject to damage from climate, like humid weather and worms. And so they are very fragile. To restore the ancient classics is no easy job. First, you need to take a picture and restore the file and decode the pages and record the pages and repair the damaged part and flatten the pieces and compress the book before they become a whole piece. And the old classics are usually easily damaged. Some I recall a case where I restored an old classics. I touched the book first and then touched my skin, and then I got uncomfortable. So they can be very dangerous. When restoring the old classics, you need to be very cautious. And some old classics have lost a word record, and they are told they are passed down by wording from mouth to mouth. So the restoration of the old classics is a race against the time. By restoring the classics, you are also talking with the ancient authors. You are talking with time. You are also training your temperament. I think I will take this as my lifelong career. Welcome, Ms. Wang Yan, the Vice Chancellor of China's Intangible Cultural Heritage Academy, and also Ms. Xu Jixiang, a protector of the restoration of the ancient classics. So, you are also named the doctors of the ancient classics. It is said that you need to be trained at least 5 years before graduation. Yes, our profession resembles doctors. We have a training base. The students are trained in a ancient classics restoration hospital. So we think this is a great job. Every time a piece of ancient classics is restored by me or by the hands of my students, and then passed into the life of other scholars and people, I think it is something very meaningful. So in this sense, we give the ancient books a second life. I hope more youngsters can join us in this profession to restore the ancient books. So the paper ancient books need these doctors, these masters, to restore and preserve them by heart. But apart from the ancient books, we have also the stone inscriptions. These also need protections from the people. Why are Chinese people so keen to preserve the ancient books? Because, as President Xi said, we need to bring the ancient books back to life and bring the characters and ideologies of the books back to life. Mr. Chen, as far as I know, the latest statistics show that the Nanjing Library accommodates 12.4 million books. That is a huge ocean of books. So which book you recommend to us today? Well, that is a difficult question. Since we are talking about Nanjing in this program, and I also moved from Yangzhou to Nanjing, I am a new resident of Nanjing. So I'd like to recommend a piece from the Chinese literature, Zhu Ziqing, called The View of Father's Back. It is about a story in 1917. The authors, it tells the story between the author and his father, and also the emotions and the innermost feelings in the heart of Chinese people. Many people would like to visit the Pukou train station after reading this book, and many people moved to Nanjing for a living after reading this book. So I think the book can change the life of many. Talking about the Pukou train station, now it has become so famous. It has attracted many visitors. The Pukou train station used to be the biggest hub, transportation hub of the Jingpu line, which became later the Beijing-Shanghai line. So it is very important hub in modern China history. So this story is about a very important period of history. So why does the author tell the history in such a simple way of in a story between father and son? I think the book is about a modern inscript. It tells not only a personal story but also a modern experience. It tells the story of the May 4th generation, the tensions between the May 4th generations of people and their fathers. It is also a tension in a cultural sense. So when the author Zhu Ziqing wrote the book, he was trying to make up with his father, emotionally speaking. It is also trying to make up, culturally speaking. I think many of us have read the piece in our school time. As we were small, we did not understand the feelings between the author and his father. I think there is a special episode about he was picking up the orange left by his father. I did not understand that chapter, but when I grew up and I was seen off by my father at the train station, I saw how he turns back. He walked back. I thought my father cried. And I asked my mom, and my mom said he did cry. And my father put a letter in my bag. It's 3 pages letter. There is a line he said, this is so much I can do about for you. So it is about the emotions between father and son. So I think we need to be more brave, to be more abrupt, to express our feelings, then things will be better. So literature is more needed. We need literature. It not only teaches us aesthetics, it also teaches us how to face our emotions. Sometimes we don't really know how to express our feelings. Thus, I think literature helps us do this. So this place, the Pukou train station, represents the place where the father of Mr. Zhu Ziqing sees him off. So there is a line in the article. We crossed the river, we entered the train station, I bought the ticket, he took care of the luggage. But there is too much luggage. we have to hire someone, pay someone to help deal with the luggage. And my father even bargained with the people. I thought I was too smart. I don't think my father was smart. So my father saw me off at the train station. He got a chair seat for me at the train. He told me to take care, and especially at night, do not get cold. And also, he asked the work staff to take care of me. But I sniffed that he was not smart. I think I was already big enough to take care of myself. But now, when looking back, I was not smart at all. So reading books is about training yourself to deal with emotions. So we expect more readers to love reading. I think Nanjing is a special city. It has found a socialized structure like bookstores. Nanjing has done very well in this respect. The bookstores is not a strict social structure. It is formed throughout the daily life. So the one thing that is most familiar to me is the back of the readers. So if you go to the parks, the dining halls over city, you must be able to find the backs of many readers, and they support the city's future. And there is another book called Massage. Can you tell us more about this book? Most people read novels, read other styles of books. But if we compare the speed of training, I think the reading is equal right to everyone. So we hope the people with sight disability can also access reading as well by printed copies, and we will provide convenience to the people. That means we will bring more classics to our blind readers. The ultimate goal of reading for me is to find the ultimate meaning of life. When I was 4 or 5 years old, I cannot see clearly. The world seemed blurred to me. It's like putting a person into jail slowly. And then you are jailed. So I only live in my own world. But reading is the turning point of my life. It records the world in the words, so it becomes my whole world. Through reading, I learned that people can laugh. What does a drop of tear express, or a laugh, a smile express? So reading is a window to me. It enables me to grasp the world, even a small part of the world. Dear students, good noon. Today I'd like to share with you the skills of speaking. I think reading is really a good thing. You can write the words, I love you, but reciting is really a good habit. You can hear the words. And later I came to know more people through in the public charity, and we participate in a competition which involves and we got an award. So I think this work involves artificial intelligence and other technologies. I think people with disabilities need to enjoy more convenience in accessing to information. I hope we can jointly make efforts to bring the world closer to this group of people. On the way to the moon, even if you did not arrive at the moon, you are on your way. So I am the reader Ye Hongting. So let's welcome Ms. Yuan Nan from Yilin Publishing House. So what book did you recommend today? So I recommend Hamlet today. It is translated by a Chinese literator Zhu Shenghao in 1943, and this is the most famous edition. And in 2016, by courtesy, a coincidence, we worked together with Birmingham University and we jointly established the first Shakespeare Research and Publishing Center in China. And this is a very good platform for us to make more efforts on promoting literature. So the literature in the platform of the Chinese literature translation can help us connect the Chinese and Western cultures and allows us to exchange and learn from each other in a joyful way. So Hamlet is really a world-renowned masterpiece. Mr. Zhu Shenghao is a very famous Chinese literator who translates the pieces of Shakespeare. He used his whole lifetime to translate the classics. So he passed away in 1944, but throughout his whole life, he did only two things. First is to translate the books of Shakespeare, and second is to love his wife and write love letters to his wife. So we need the translators to help us to open up the window to the foreign literature. Next, I'd like to show you a video clip for you to know an excellent translator. Goodbye. The fox says, this is my secret. The book is like the branch, the trunk of a plant. So the branch gives a life, is a new life. So translating the princess, the little prince, is always a thing that I want to do. The book involves very simple words, but it's really a challenge to the interpreter, to the translator. For example, there is a word, a French word, apovase. You may use train or tame, I mean in Chinese, but I thought about it many times. So in the end, I chose tame or xunfu in Chinese. I think in translation, you need to present the authentic meaning of the text in order to present what lies the cultural sense that lies behind the words. We have established many Chinese, French workshops, and I have a friend, Ma Ting, and we jointly translated the Countryside China, a Chinese book. We also translated the works of Liu Cixin about the three body. So our works have been translated, and they are also circulated in France. So I'm the reader Huang Hong. So, Mr. Ke Jun, what's this story about? It's about a dream of a Chinese man who aspires to become an official. But when he woke up, he found it was just a dream. Well, this is the first time that I was so close to the performers. This has brought me even closer to the literature. So, Kunqu opera, this form of play has brought people closer to Kunqu opera and to more famous classic pieces. So, the Handan Dream, we can talk more in detail about it in our meeting room, in the workshop, in the program. Welcome, Mr. Ke Jun. We just watched the performance of Handan Dream of the actresses and actors. There was a play that was performed in the UK, and that was the first English performance of a Chinese play. So this Handan Dream is also in bilingual versions. I think opera and literature are interconnected. Only by combining the two can we move closer towards philosophy. So by watching this performance, the audience must be thinking that they are having a dialogue with the time. Well, in 2019, I was in the town of Shakespeare, and he passed away in 1616. Well, wasn't the year that the Chinese literator Tang Xianzu passed away? So I thought I may come up with a new play. I used 7 years to come up with this text. And there was a case that the servant told me there was no electricity, and that suddenly I was touched upon because 400 years ago, there was no electricity. So the play must be touching the heart of the people. So in the play, we use candles instead of electricity. So we need a window for demonstration. Well, Nanjing is nothing, anything different. You know, Peking Opera belongs to Beijing. Xi Opera belongs to Wuxi. We also have the Yang Opera and the Huai Opera. But Nanjing has become a stage for collecting different styles of opera. So we are also lucky as the artist of Ke Jun. I think things may have changed, but at least in the time of Shakespeare and in the time of Tang Xianzu, the opera first in its first nature is can be wrote in words before being read. So in the great times, Shakespeare and Tang Xianzu left us a very important literature classics in our time-honored history.
Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer
the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune.
枪不知所起，一往而深，生辄可疑死，色可疑生.
Or to take arms against a sea of troubles, and by opposing anthem, to die, to sleep.
一切苦乐兴衰，难科无二，等为蒙境。 何处生天?
No more, and by a sleep to see, we end the heartache and thousands natural shocks.
That flesh is here too.
'Tis a consummation.
Devoutly to be wished.
To die, to sleep.
生者是非死者，所起一往而深。
今天呀，我们在文学客厅畅聊文学。其实，静子老师，我知道关于文学，您说过这么一句话：文学就是把大地上各种不相干的事情以及像星辰一样散落在天空上的事情连接起来，拼成一幅美妙的星图。那符合您推荐标准的，一定是集大成之作。静子老师，今天要为我们推荐哪本书呢？
哎呀，我这本书其实，但凡是中国人，我觉得差不多都知道。 《红楼梦》，刚才我们在谈莎士比亚，有1000个读者，就有1000个哈姆雷特。对，其实我觉得也可以用在《红楼梦》上，它是让我们认识历史，认识那个已经逝去的社会，领会生活与情感的复杂与深微，也有通过这个《红楼梦》要学习社会的，学习怎么与人相处的，学习人情世故的，啊。
Through reading, you learn how to behave in your normal life. For example, in the Chinese classics, Dream in the Red Mansions, you learn, you observe how people eat, dress, and talk, and interact with people. So if you travel back to the night in 1763, when you meet with the author Cao Xueqin, I'd like to ask him and tell him how we understand the book. The way that we understand the book may be beyond imagination or beyond the understanding of the author. Actually, it's the same for any classics. It is not written by just one author. It is read by generations of readers. Each generation of readers give their thoughts, their way of the world, and their outlook on the world and the people about the book. So everyone has its own understanding of this book. So when you try to interpret, you want to see the book or see the life of a person, you can find your own understanding. You can find the way you can echo with the book. So it must be very interesting to read the book in the Nanjing dialect, but it will be more interesting to sing the book in opera. The book A Dream in the Red Mansions is a lighthouse in the Yue Opera. When I came to the Yue Opera class, my teacher said I can play the male role, the Jia Bao Yu, in this book. I was so interested, so I applied for this major. Well, I am Li Xiaoxu, the male character in the Yue Opera. Ms. Li has performed for over 20 years. She has won a lot of awards, and behind her success, she has paid a lot of efforts. A reading can help me go deeper into the heart of the character. In 2018, she performed in a play and was and won the highest honor in China's opera, the Chrysanthemum Award. And I starred the role of Li Bai. When I got the role, I was so intimidated. I didn't think I can do the job. But the play is about a love story of Li Bai and the three stories in his life. In the fourth episode, the opening of the fourth episode, it seems like this. I left the city, the emperor's city, in the morning. So this is how I sing. But the director said I got it wrong. So I started to reflect. In order to better play the role, Ms. Li found many books about Li Bai. After reading more and more, she became to understand the heart of Li Bai. I returned back to the city in just 1 day. Well, the play was a huge success, and it applies a new way of performance. She attracted a lot of young audience. So I think myself as a young actress of passing the beauty of the opera. So I'd like to bring the glamour of the books back onto the stage and to share with our people. So we need more craftsmen to improve the traditional traditional tools. So the life of these tools lies in the innovation. If they cannot enter our life, they cannot become our experience, then it is just one item in the library. So we must treasure and respect, despite our respect and appreciation, it is still in the library. So as President Xi Jinping said, the right attitude towards the culture is to think up new ways to pass them down, to bring the culture back to life. So how to make them alive? That is to bring them back, bring them into the daily life of the people. So that is to bring the life of the ancient people into the life of the modern people. We need a new methods, and we need to tell new stories of the time. And that represents our aspiration for truth and beauty. The Nanjing Mountain is beyond, is very beautiful. It is the capital of six dynasties. We have very tall city walls. Well, it's full of lies. It's full of tears. People say the author is stupid. So, a girl and a boy has special connections to meet each other. They are meant for each other. These are the lines from the book. In Nanjing, we are experiencing thousands of years of culture, and Nanjing now has a new name card, the UNESCO, the World City of Literature. So how can we make the name card even brighter? We need to do two things. I'd like to introduce to you two our representatives, Mr. Pan Guping. Mr. Pan is the council president of Nanjing Literature Association, and Ms. Yuan Shuang, the UNESCO official contact person in Nanjing. So what do you think is the biggest meaning of Nanjing? How can we empower Nanjing? Good evening, everyone. It's my great pleasure to meet you here and share with you my thoughts on literature. We have established the literature meeting rooms, the literature libraries, and literature towns, and also a couple of other IPs combined with tourism, creativity, and business, and also films. We'd like to integrate literature with these forms of culture to help Nanjing develop further. Well, the first literature library was built 18,000 years ago, 1800 years ago. It represents the change in time. I think it is a transformation of the city of Nanjing. How can we together build Nanjing into a classic, a socialist modern city that people are content with? We need to work together toward this goal. Well, Nanjing is the world city of literature. It is also a bridge that connects China and the foreign literature and the civilizations. Is it correct? Yes, Nanjing is renowned as the world city of literature. It is a very active platform. Now we have 42 cities of literature. They form a circle of friends. The cities are making many initiatives. When we talk about the city of literature, for example, the Melbourne from Australia, for example, the Seattle from America, and also Nanjing from China. It is China's Nanjing. So Nanjing is a window to pass the Chinese culture. We are building a community of shared future for mankind. So in Nanjing, we are building a community of shared literature for mankind. Today is the World Book Day. Talking about books, reading is not limited to only this day, but also every day. We have read much. We are readers. I think we will keep reading in the future. So what is your deepest feeling, most truthful feeling about reading? Well, Nanjing Library is an important method for preserving the Nanjing literature of Jiangsu province. We have the responsibility, we have the mission, and we are confident that we will do our utmost to promote the literature in Nanjing and to promote quality development, and we will make our due contribution. Thank you. Mr. B, well, literature expands our life. Well, at the hub of the world's literature, as a reader from Nanjing, an author, a teacher, I like to say a good book is like meeting a good soil, a soul. You and I meet in a good book, in a good city, amid mountains and rivers. Mr. Jingze, it is in reading that we can connect with the distant world, the infinite distant world, and can we connect spiritually speaking, and can we have dialogue and in-depth communication with our ancestors? It is in reading that we can deeply feel we are in a great tradition, that we can deeply feel we are embedded by a rich world civilization. I think for the youngsters, reading is the biggest value of reading is to create more knowledge. And it is also useful for me to appreciate the beauty of the world. Once you open the book, the world is all there for you. So reading is for everyone. Reading helps us become better, becomes more beautiful and more sincere. That's why we meet together in Beijing for the World Book Day on April 23rd. I think you will find your visit worthful, and I hope you can find this program useful and insightful. Well, thank you. Thank you for coming and thank you for joining us. Thank you. Let's travel through the words and experience the beauty of the world in reading. Thank you. Bye-bye.